Hello and welcome. This is Jonsbo HP600, a 66mm height CPU cooler with a 120mm fan. The overall heatsink design should be familiar since this is the most commonly used design. Do note that it is using a slim 120mm fan with 15mm thickness. There is a trade-off to be had. A regular 120mm fan do push more air. But, if they used a thin, 15mm fan, the heatsink would have more thermal mass. Heatsink manufacturers rarely choose to use regular thickness 120mm fans. Intel should really copy AMD's integrated backplate. It makes any heatsink installation much easier and faster. But, I guess, from Intel's point of view, having to spend a bit more for the backplates may be too much for them. After about 5 minutes, the temperature settled down at around 79 degrees Celsius. Compared to other coolers of the same class and the same design, HP600 falls a bit behind by about 5%. I suppose this is within the margin of error. I am now going to test this cooler on Ryzen 7600X. From Ryzen 7000 series and upwards, CPU temperature works very differently from Intel, therefore I am inclined to include both if possible. The default TJ Max is 75 degrees Celsius. I am also going to include a result for 95 centigrade TJ Max. After about 5 minutes, it looks like all core turbo clock speed is stable at 5.09 GHz. Yes, when testing Ryzen CPU, you look at the turbo clock speed instead of the temperature, because it's always going to be maxed out for low-profile coolers. Now let's see what difference it makes for 95 Celsius TJ Max. At 95 Celsius TJ Max, it looks like the turbo clock speed is stable at 5.15 GHz. The extra 20 degrees doesn't seem to make much of a difference. You are gaining a painfully small increase of just 0.06 GHz. In that case, I'd rather stay with 75 Celsius TJ Max. Anyway, in conclusion, It's not a bad low-profile cooler. I would say that this is strictly average. There was no weird quirks to speak of, and its price is also on average compared to others. Well, thank you for watching and see you next time.